वंदे भगवंत ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेदे भागिने देहाय तस् प्रणोति तस्मै तगुंहदेवमात्मबुद्धि प्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्री चिद्घनगणेशाय नमो। मह्यं सुखं नित्यं सुप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपनिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक्यत्वेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं तदेवाहं त्वन्निति निश्चितामतिः। सो लुकिंग एट सांख्या बीइंग टॉट टू अग्रज देवा इन स्वप्न। सो देयर आर पंचविंशति तत्वाज इन सांख्य मत। सांख्य मते ईश्वर न अंगीक्रियते। सो तत्त्वम् तत्त्वमिति पदार्थस्य नाम। देन वी सॉ सांख्य मते ईश्वर न अंगीक्रियते। देयर इज अ टिप्पण ऑन दैट। सेश्वर सांख्य निरीश्वर सांख्य भेदात् सांख्य मतम् द्विविधम्। इन सांख्य सांख्य दर्शन देयर आर टू मतास्। One has Ishvara, the other does not have Ishvara. They don't accept Ishvara in the other Sankhya Mata. Sorry. Kardama Deva Kutyo Putraha Bhagavad Avatara Kapilaha Seshvara Sankhya Matam Angi Karoti. So Kapila Muni accepts Ishvara. Anyaha Pi Kapila Abhut. There is another Kapila. So that Kapila saha Nirishvara Sankhya Matam Angi Krutavan. Since the name is also same, there is confusion as to Sankhya being Nirishvara Darshana, but there is also Seshvara Sankhya Darshana. So Tasya Mate Ishvara Na Angi Kriyate in the latter Kapila's opinion. किंतु प्रधानमेव जगत कारणमिति पुरुषस्य भोग मोक्ष कारणमिति च अंगीक्रियते। सो प्रधान प्रकृति माया इज द जगत कारण, वेयर एज पुरुष ब्रह्म इज अ भोक्ता। सो भोग मोक्ष कारणम। सो दिस इज प्राइमरी व्हाट इज कंसीडर्ड एज द Sankhya Mata, where Ishvara is not accepted, and that is refuted by Bhagavan Bhashyakara, where Pradhana is Jada. Prakriti being Jada cannot be Karana by itself. It has to have some basis. So even if you say Upadana Karana, okay, Upadana Karana. But the Upadana Karana does not automatically start making Karya. You need a Nimitta to handle or influence the Upadana Karana in some way, by mere presence. In our case, it is by mere presence. Purusha being Chetana, by mere presence, influence the Jada to act, Jada Pradhana to act. Further, one who is not a Karta cannot be a Bhokta. At an individual level, Purusha, there is a special Purusha in Sankhya. All Purushas are Chetana. There are multiple Purushas. There is a special Purusha who is Ishvara, who we consider as Ishvara. In their case, that Purusha is not Ishvara per se. He has nothing to do with the Pradhana creating the Jagat, but he is a Bhokta. So Pradhana influences by itself, without any influence per se, in the presence of Ishvara, but Ishvara in the sense, we look at Purusha as Ishvara. They say that Purusha is a Chetana Vastu. That Purusha has nothing to do with Pradhana creating. Pradhana by itself, without any connection to the Chetana, we say that Brahma, Chetana Brahma is Ashraya of Pradhana or Prakriti. They don't accept the Ashrayatvam. They say Pradhana is completely separate and it is really existent. We don't accept the reality of Pradhana. We say it is Mithya. Maya is Anumeya and it is Mithya. They say Pradhana is as Satya as Brahma. It is Jagat Karna, has no connection to Purusha. So there is real Dvaita in the beginning itself. And then there are many Purushas who are Jivas, what we call as Jivas. They are Bhoktas. Without being Karta, they are Bhokta. This Purusha also, Chetana is a Bhokta without being a Karta, which is against the law of karma. And this Purusha Bhoga Moksha Karanam iti cha Angi Kriyate. Moksha is also attained by this Purusha, not by Pradhana. Tadetat na sangachyate. This is not valid, not acceptable. Why? Pralaya kale sattvadi gunanam samyavastha pradhanam iti. Srishti kale yada tat pradhanam samyavastham tyajati. Tada jagad upadyate iti cha te kathayanti. So they say that there is a samyavastha of Sattva, Rajas and Tamas. When there is Pralaya. So these three gunas are in balance. They are in equilibrium. At the moment of Srishti, what happens is that Pradhanam Samyavastham Tejati. Pradhana gives up the Samyavastha of all the three gunas. They go out of balance. They go out of balance because there is Srishti due. There is Prarabdha Bhoga to be done by Jivas. Based on that, the Sattva, Rajas and Tamo Gunas go out of balance appropriately for that kind of a Srishti. Tada Jagad Utpadyate iti cha te kathayanti. Tanna Yuktam. That is not acceptable. Why? We agree with the part of Srishti being in keeping with the gunas, gunas going out of balance because of the earlier Srishti being in a particular manner, the next Srishti will be continuation of that. So gunas go out of balance at an appropriate moment, but not by themselves. Pradhanasya jadatvat svataha eva tat samyavastha parityaga samartham na bhavati. So pradhanam samyavastham tyajati, kartari prayoga tyajati. Kim tyajati, kaha tyajati, ka tyajati, prakriti hi, maya, swayameva. So pradhanam is neuter, so pradhanam samyavastham tyajati, pradhana is karta, samyavastham is karma. How can pradhana, which is jada, give up the samyavastha on its own? So, swata eva tat pradhanam jadatvat, tasyeva pradhanasya jadatvat, swata eva samyavastha parityaga samartham na bhavati. By itself, it cannot give up anything. You cannot say mrit will stop being mrit and starts becoming ghata. That is not possible. Why? Mritaha jadatvat. Similarly here, pradhanasya jadatvat, it cannot by itself give up the samyavastha. Chetanasya purushasya tanmate sankhyamate asangatvat natasya pradhanena sambandho bhavati. So there is no, they don't accept that there is sangha. Mithya sambandha also they do not accept. They say both are real. There is no sambandha between them at all. There is no sangha, association. We say there is association. Shakti Shaktiman sambandha has to be accepted. Purusha is Shaktiman who has Pradhana as Shakti. They don't accept that connection at all. Therefore, Chetanasya Purushasya Tanmate Asangatvat Natasya Pradhanena Sambandho Bhavati. सो असंग पुरुष कैनॉट हैव संबंध विद प्रधान चेतन संबंध विना जड़म न किंचिदपि कार्यम उत्पादयितुं शक्नोति देन हाउ इज इट दैट दिस जड़ा क्रिएट्स द जगत विच इटसेल्फ इज जड़ा तस्मात् प्रधान रूप माया विशिष्टं चैतन्यं अंतर्यामी ईश्वरो भवति स एव जगत कर्ता इत्येव सांख्येन अपि अभ्युपगन्तुम् उचितम् सिंस जड़ा कैनॉट डू एनीथिंग देयर हैज टू बी सम चेतना बैकिंग इट देयर हैज टू बी सम काइंड ऑफ संबंध बिटवीन देम यू हैव टू एक्सेप्ट सम कनेक्शन बिटवीन चेतना एंड जड़ा इवन बाय सांख्य इट हैज टू बी एक्सेप्टेड अदरवाइज प्रधान बाय इटसेल्फ कैनॉट बी जगत्कर्ता किंच आत्मनः नानात्वस्य प्रकृतेः नित्यत्वस्य सो किंच आत्मनः नानात्वस्य प्रकृतेः नित्यत्वस्य च अंगीकारं कुर्वतः आत्मनि सजातीय आत्मांतर संबंधस्य विजातीय प्रकृति संबंधस्य च अपरिहार्यत्वात् नाना आत्मनात्म संगत्व उक्ति व्याहता भवेत् सो आत्मा इज नॉट वन नाना आत्मा एंड प्रकृति इज नित्य सो दोस द सांख्यवादी हु एक्सेप्ट दिस आत्मनि सजातीय आत्मांतर संबंधस्य विजातीय प्रकृति संबंधस्य च अपरिहार्यत्वात् सो आत्मा बीइंग मेनी देयर इज अनदर आत्मा सजातीय आत्मांतर संबंधस्य देयर इज अ संबंध बिटवीन वन आत्मा एंड द अदर आत्मा देयर एंड विजातीय प्रकृति संबंधस्य दिस प्रकृति इज आत्मभिन्न अनात्म दैट आल्सो संबंध विजातीय प्रकृति संबंध से च अपरिहार्यत्वात् नाना आत्मनाम असंगत्व उक्तिर व्याहता भवेत् सो देयर इज सम कॉम्प्लिकेटेड तर्क देयर आत्मा आर एक्सेप्टेड टू बी मेनी आत्मा इज सेट टू हैव नो संबंध विद प्रधान प्रधान बीइंग जड़ा इज ऑल्सो जगत्कर्ता एंड फर्दर आत्मा इज भोक्ता प्रकृति इज नित्य सो सो मेनी कॉम्प्लेक्सिटीज आर देयर नाउ दिस आत्मा बीइंग मेनी देयर इज सजातीय आत्मा एंड इफ यू लुक एट द संबंध बिटवीन वन आत्मा एंड दी अदर आत्मा व्हाट इज द संबंध सजातीय दे बिलोंग टू द सेम स्पीशीज बिकॉज आत्मा कैन नॉट बी डिफरेंट अमोंग ऑल द आत्मास आत्मा इज सेम नाउ दिस प्रकृति इज अनात्मा इट इज नित्य देयर इज अ यू हैव टू एक्सेप्ट अ कनेक्शन दो विदाउट विच देयर कैनॉट बी अपरिहार्य देयर कैनॉट बी अ जगत सृष्टि नाउ नाना आत्मनाम असंगत्वोक्ति व्याहता भवेत् द असंगत्व विच हैज बीन टॉक्ड अबाउट आत्मा इज असंग हाउ डू यू से आत्मा इज असंग वेन There is a sangha which has to be accepted. Jada cannot create anything. Therefore, nana atmanam asangatukti made by whom? By sankhyavadi. Vyahata bhavet. Have to give up. You cannot hold on to asanga atmana. Vyapakasya ekasya atmanah angikare. Nana antakkarana rupa upadhi prayukta bhogadhyasang. कर्य व्यवस्था सिद्ध्यति। वॉट यू आर ट्राइंग टू अचीव विथ नाना आत्मा यू कैन डू विथ वन आत्मा ऑल्सो। व्यापकस्य एकस्य आत्मनः अंगीकारे नानांता अंतकरण उपाधि प्रयुक्त भोगाद्यसंकर्य व्यवस्था सिद्ध्यति तस्माद् आत्मनानात्वोपगमः विफलः। सो द लॉ ऑफ पार्सिमनी ऑकाम्स रेजर इज यू टेक द सिंपलेस्ट ऑप्शन व्हेन यू कैन एक्सप्लेन विदाउट नाना आत्मा देन why would you use nana atma? Nana antakkaranas are anyway accepted by everyone. Now on top of it you don't need to accept nana atma, because atma is vyapaka, all pervasive atma, and multiple all pervasive atmas is logically flawed. Vyapakasya ekasya atmanah angikare. If you accept one atma which is vyapaka, then you accept antakkarana being many, they become the upadhi for atma, the single atma, then bhoga ityadi, all this can be explained, this vyavastha can be explained. So why do you need nana atma? Tasmad atma nanatva upagamaha viphalaha. There is no special benefit of accepting nana atma. Atma nana tu abhyupagame advaita shruti virodascha. If you still insist, no, let there be gaurava, but this is the philosophy, this is the darshana, then that darshana is opposed to advaita shruti. You cannot explain advaita shruti at all. Ekame va dvitiya brahma, you cannot explain. How will you explain that? You'll have to set aside some Shruti Vakyas and pick only those which are acceptable to your darshana. Others you set aside, you don't need to talk about it. If someone asks, you talk about it as Arthavada maybe. Or like the moderners, add words to the Shruti, misinterpret it, or force some Vyakrana rules and apply, or apply rules which are not found in any Vyakrana Shastra, do some unacceptable padas cheda or samasa and explain. Or like karma kandis, just say that these are all arthavadas. That can't be right. Advaitin is the only darshanika who can explain each and every Shruti Vakya by accepting them at a different level of reality, applicable to a different level of field, applicable to different set of people, applicable to people who have different goals. Thereby all Shruti Vakyas as they are valid. This only Advaitin can do. Therefore, everyone else who talks about Atma Nanatva, they have advaita shruti virodha. Atma veda bhadaka yuktayaha cha uttaratra pradarshishyante. Then atma veda bhadaka yuktayaha. The shruti virodha has been shown. There is logical virodha also. There is a logical flaw if you start analyzing nana atmas also. They will contradict their acceptance of bheda in atma. Whether it is swajatiya, vijatiya, swagata, whatever you accept, that bheda will be countered by logic. It will not stand scrutiny. That will be shown later. Tasmad asangatam sankhyamatam. Right now, shruti virodha is shown and therefore sankhyamata as it is not acceptable. Some parts are acceptable. Where there is no virodha and we don't really want to argue where Shruti has no tatparya. If it can work, we don't need to reinvent the wheel. We say, okay, so many tattvas are there. They have done enough research. We say it is okay. We accept all that. all these tattvas, but as soon as they start contradicting the Shruti, we object. Further in the Moola, Swatantra Prakriti Eva Jagatak Karanam Bhavati. Purushasya Bhoga Moksha Nimittam Prakriti Reva Pravartate. Purushaha Na Pravartate. So Prakriti Eva Jagat Karanam Bhavati, Jagataha Karanam Bhavati, we saw that. Now Purushasya Bhoga Moksha Nimittam Prakriti Eva Pravartate. Purushaha Na Pravartate. Purusha is not a karta. If Purusha is not a karta, being a bhokta, he just sits in wait mood. Prakriti will do something and get me bhoga. Similarly, Prakriti will do something and then get me moksha also. Prakriti he visherupa parinamat purushasya bhoga bhavati. How does the purusha get bhoga? When Prakriti is in samyavastha, purusha has no bhoga. When Prakriti has given up the samyavastha and the gunas go out of balance, then what will happen? They change, there is karya, vikriti, and this vikriti will, vikaras, all the karyas will become bhoga karana for purusha. Buddhi dvara viveka rupa prakriti parinamat moksha siddhyati. How does moksha take place then? Moksha takes place when buddhi, which is also vikara, vikriti, when buddhi dvara viveka rupa prakriti parinama takes place, tasmat karanati, prakriti changes into what? Viveka rupa. How? Because buddhi, which is also vikara, has those kind of vrittis, which allows viveka, which can differentiate between purusha and prakriti, then this person gets moksha, purusha gets moksha. Atma, not person per se. Purusha, who is separate, nana atma, that gets moksha. Yadyapi purushasya asangatva tasmin bhoga moksha na sambhavatah, tathapi jnana sukha dukha ragadveshadeha buddhev parinama bhavanti. So there is an objection to this Sankhya Mata. How do you say that Purusha has bhoga and moksha when Purusha is asanga, asanga Purusha? Asanga Purusha cannot have bhoga or moksha. Then they say, oh, it is possible. Tathapi jnana sukha dukha ragadveshadeha buddhev parinama bhavanti. Tasyaha buddhehe atmana saha avivekaha asti. Vivekastu nasti. Tasmad atmani aropitau bandhamokshau sambhavatah. So, coming close to Siddhanta. Atmani aropitau bandhamokshau sambhavatah. Bandha and moksha are superimposed on atma. Now, this is where Vedanta finds closeness to Sankhya. Therefore, Sankhya is the primary opponent, main Purvapaksha to Vedanta, because we accept this. In Atma, Bandha Moksha is Aropita. Now, the way Bandha Moksha is Aropita, in Asanga Atma, Veda is also Aropita. As if they accept that, then there won't be much to refute. Buddhi parinama, buddhi is also vikara. Parinama is what? Jnana, sukha, dukha, raga, dvesha. This is also acceptable to us. Buddhi parinama, antakkarana vritti. Then tasya buddhehe atmana sa aviveka asti. Adhyasa, there is some mix-up. Mishrikaranam. Maithuni Karanam says Bhagavan Bhashyakara in Adhyasa Bhashya. Yushmad and Asmad Pratyah have got mixed up. Buddhi, where there is idam pratyaya should be there, which is called as yushmat pratyaya in adhyasa bhashya. And atma, the real atma, the vritti there is aham, aham vritti. That aham vritti and idam vritti have got mixed up. In adhyasa bhashya, asmad vritti and yushmad, they have got mixed up. That is the aviveka here, getting mixed up, mithuni karanam. So adhyasa is both ways, buddhi, which is jada, buddhi, not only buddhi, buddhi, and then you go outward from the sukshma sharira, stula sharira also. So all the attributes, dharmas, so we say dharmas. So dharma can be an attribute also, dharma can be swabhava also, swarupa. In atma's case, swarupa, satchidananda dharma is swarupa. Buddhi dharma is jadatva. And so many others, karyatvam is there. All of these dharmas of the buddhi and all the vikaras also. Anatma has all the, a subject to all the shadvikaras. All the shadvikaras of the buddhi and all the buddhi extended to manas, antakkarana, the emoting mind. All the emotions are also dharmas of the buddhi. So jnana, sukha, dukha, raga, dvesha, all these are buddhi parinamas, buddhi vrittis. They become buddhi, they are buddhi dharmas. Somehow they are superimposed upon oneself. Whereas buddhi is going to wither away in time, I think that I am going to wither away in time. Then atma, which is sat, chit and ananda, buddhi being jada also appears to be chetana because of atma dharma superimposed on buddhi. Buddhi appears to be existing itself because of atma satta being superimposed on buddhi. That there is sukha vritti in the buddhi, that is possible because of atma being ananda swarupa, superimposed on buddhi. So both ways there is adhyasa. This is that hridaya granthi, which is avidya, manifest by throwing the dharmas of atma and anatma on each other. That is avidya karya. So tasya buddhi atmanasa aviveka asti. Very difficult to differentiate. Viveka astu nasti. There is no discrimination possible between these two. On its own, it is not possible. Tasmad atmani aropito bandha mokshav sambhavataha. Although this bhoga mokshav, so bandha is used here, bandha bhoga is also Badaka, it is Bandhakarana. So, Bhoga Mokshav or Bandha Mokshav Purushasya Asangatvat Na Sambhavataha, but Viveka Rahitatvat Aropitatvat Bandha Mokshav Sambhavataha Atmani. Asange Atmani. In Asanga Atma, it is still possible by aropa, meaning it isn't real. Mithya, another way to say it is mithya. So Sankhya also has a concept of mithya without using that word. Paramarthata atma na bhokta. But in reality, what is it? The fact is that atma is not bhokta. Sankhya think that atma is bhokta, but paramarthata atma na bhokta. Buddhi reva bhoktri. Buddhi is bhoktri. So aviveka siddhau yaha atmani bhogaha tenaiva sankhyamate atma bhokta iti kathyate. When sankhyas also talk about atma being bhokta, that is aviveka siddha. The bhoga in atma is due to aviveka. Paramarthata atma na bhokta buddhireva bhoktri. So buddhi is the experiencer by borrowing the chetanatva from atma, buddhistu atmanaha bhinna. Buddhi is different from atma. Idrisha jnanasya viveka iti sanya. Viveka is knowing this difference between atma and anatma, buddhi and atma. Idrisha jnana bhava eva aviveka iti. And what is aviveka? Not knowing that buddhi is different from me. Itthancha sankhyamate atma asangha asti. So atma is asangha. Sangarahita. Sukhadaya buddhe parinamatvat. Buddhe reva dharma. And sukadukha. All these are buddhi parinama. And therefore buddhi dharma atma nana cha. But atma is accepted as nana. Now we say you don't need to accept atma. Atma nana tum. Because Bheda can also be said. Nanatva is also superimposed on Eka Atma. Atra evam Siddhanta. What is a Siddhanta really? Tadetat Sankhyamatam Atyantam Atyanta Viruddham. This Atyanta Viruddha is basically primarily at Atma Nanatvam. But then there are others also. If we start arguing on this, if they accept this, then we can ignore the others. They don't accept this. Atma being Eka, they don't accept. So we have to look at other things also and find, show them flaws there also. Sukha dukkhadi naam atma dharmatve tesham prati shariram bhedad atmana bheda siddhyet. If the sukha dukkha dharmas were atma dharmas, really, not aropita, then atma bheda between atma 1 and atma 2 and atma 3 and atma n, there would be differences. But sukha dukkhas are not atma dharmas at all. Then how would you prove atma nanatva at all? You cannot say sukatvat. Devadattasya sukatvat, yajnadattasya dukkhatvat. Yajnadatta devadattad bhinnaha. This is something that you say, but devadatta is not atma, who is bhinna from yajnadatta as atma. Devadatta's antakkarana is different from yajnadatta's antakkarana, buddhi. And devadatta's sukha is devadatta buddhi gata dharma. Yajnaratta's dukkha is yajnaratta's buddhi gata dharma. Dukkha is different from sukha because antakkaranas are different. Atma is not different. You cannot even prove that atma is different. Tachcha sukha dukkhadikam na atmana dharma kintu buddhereva dharma tasmat. Sukha dukkhadi bhedad buddhi bheda eva siddhye. You can establish only antakkarana bheda between devadatta and yajnaratta, natu atmanaha bhedaha siddhye. You cannot establish bheda between devadatta and yajnaratta as atma. Yatha ekasmin vyapake akashe nana upadhinam dharmaha upadhyakashe yur avivekat pratiyante tathaiva. Ekasmin vyapake atmani nana buddhi nam dharmaha buddhyatmanoho avivekat pratiyanta ityubhyupagamaha eva sankhyamate api uchitaha. So the Vedanti is suggesting to the Sankhya as to it is appropriate to accept something which does not have an issue with logic, which does not have any opposition to Shruti. To insist on something which has Shruti Virodha, whereby you cannot explain the Advaita Shrutis, and in that insistence you cannot logically prove it either, there is a flaw. In that insistence there is a flaw. It is Hata. Why would you accept something which cannot be proven? You cannot show it as logically valid. You cannot show it tracing back to Shruti. Why would you hold on to it? So, what is Uchita? What is appropriate? In your Mata also, Sankhya Mata, that Viveka Aviveka drives the Atma Anatma difference or oneness. This is something that you accepted. Why not accept Bheda also similarly? Due to Viveka or Aviveka. Bheda, Abheda, respectively. Just like in Akasha, due to many Upadis, there can be non-difference or difference based on what? Based on Aviveka. So one ghata, another ghata, ghatakasha 1, ghatakasha 2, this can be nama, namakrita, bheda, due to aviveka. And if you keep something in one pot, you keep garlic in one pot, it starts stinking. The other pot does not have garlic. It doesn't stink. When you compare, you say this ghatakasha stinks, whereas this, the other ghatakasha does not stink. That akasha has nothing to do with the stink at all. That dharma does not belong to akasha. Aviveka krita. So these dharmas, nana upadinam dharma, the air particles or the ghata itself, particles of the ghata have the stink of garlic, but you confuse that to be in the akasha. Upadhyakashayor avivekat pratiyanti. Because you cannot differentiate between the smell belonging to the air which is contained in the pot which is stinking. It has nothing to do with the akasha within. That time, this misunderstanding is possible. Similarly, tatha eva ekasmin vyapake atmani, in this one vyapaka atma, which is never segmented, nana buddhi nam antakkarana nam dharmaha buddhi atmano ho avivekat pratiyante. Iti abhyupagama eva sankhyamate api uchitaha. So you extend it to a single atma, like single akasha, you cannot have many atmas, because even with one atma, the dharmas of the buddhis, antakkaranas, which are many, the bheda can be explained, vyavastha can be explained even with single atma. Atmanam asangatvena abhyupagamaha, atmanam asangatvena abhyupagamya. Tasya nanatvangi karaha nishphala eva. There is no prayojana at all in accepting nana atma. You cannot prove it either. So you may say, you know, I can't prove it, but there is a benefit to accepting. What is the benefit? You want to explain the vyavastha. Sukha dukkha bheda, karma bhoga bheda, all these vyavasthas, all these in the vyavastha can be explained even without that gaurava. You can accept single atma and still explain the vyavastha. Therefore, there is no additional benefit at all in accepting nana atma. So, atma being asanga and still having some sangha with these dharmas, it's contradictory. So, you have to see Viveka, make Viveka, differentiate between the Atma and Anatma, then you know these dharmas are different. Asanga Atma cannot have any association with dharma, whereby you can segment the Atma also. You cannot. Therefore, on the one hand, saying that Atma is Asanga, and then saying they are many. Why? Because Sukha Dukkha, these dharmas are different. Yajyaratta is Sukhi, देवदत्ता इज सुखी, यज्ञदत्ता इज दुखी. हाउ डू यू कॉन्ट्राडिक्ट यूर ओन सेल्फ बाई सेइंग दैट यज्ञदत्ता इज आत्मा इज दुखी, देवदत्ता इज आत्मा इज सुखी, एंड देयर बाय से नाना आत्मा, बट दैट दुख एंड सुख हैज नथिंग टू डू विद आत्मा बिकॉज आत्मा इज असंग. सो ऑन दी वन हैंड यू से दैट आत्मा यज्ञदत्ता इज आत्मा हैज नथिंग टू डू विद दी दुख बिकॉज आत्मा इज असंग, देवदत्ता इज आत्मा हैज नथिंग टू डू विद सुख बिकॉज देवदत्ता इज आत्मा इज ऑल्सो असंग. देन वाई डू नीड दिस adjective as devadatta's atma or yajnadatta's atma? You don't need that at all. Either you say it is asanga or you create bheda on dharma. Then you cannot say asanga. So saying asanga and then using that sukha dukkhadi sanga dharma sanga for the atma, you are creating this nana atma. You are explaining this nanatva of atma, which is not needed. Nanatva can be explained while being a single asanga atma. Due to aviveka, there is dharma bheda, dharmi bheda, and thereby nana atma pratiti, bheda pratiti. So there is no additional phala for it. Kincha kechana atmanah muktaha kechana buddhascha, sorry, baddhascha bhavanti. So some are mukta, some atma are baddha. Ittham bandha mokshayoho bhedad atma bhedaha siddhyati iti api asangatam eva. Then saying that some are mukta atmas, some are mukta purushas, some are baddha purushas, thereby bandha moksha bheda also you are talking about, but bandha moksha is also what? It is like sukha dukkha, it is aropita. So you need not say that, okay, devadatta is mukta, yajnadatta is baddha jiva, therefore there is jiva bheda, therefore there is purusha bheda, therefore there is atma bheda. You have already said that bandha moksha is also aropita. Now if it is aropita, you need not say that moksha is aropita on devadatta's atma, whereas bandhatva is aropita on yajnadatta's atma. You don't need that at all because there need not be two atmas. The way the bheda is superimposed, which is superimposed the way sukha dukkha has been superimposed. So you accept sukha dukkha superimposed on atma. We take you a little further and say this bheda also, nanatva of atma also is superimposed on one atma. You don't need sukha dukkha vyavastha to be explained by nana atma. You don't need nanatma for bheda to be established. You don't need nanatma for karma vyavastha to be established. And therefore, you don't need nanatma to establish some purushas being mukta and some purushas being baddha. Yadi bandha mokshav atmani angi kriyete, tada bandha moksha bhedad atmanah bhedah siddhye. तौच बंध मोक्षो सांख्यमते असंगे आत्मनि न अंगीक्रियते. सो यू डोंट एक्सेप्ट द बंध मोक्ष एज रियल फॉर आत्मा. इफ इट इज रियल, इफ बंध इज रियल फॉर आत्मा, आत्मा विल नेवर गेट मोक्ष. सो व्हाट डिड यू से? यू से सेड दैट व्हेन वी ऑब्जेक्टेड एज यद्यपि पुरुषस्य, यद्यपि इज हिज आंसर, वी ऑब्जेक्टेड पुरुषस्य असंगत्वात् तस्मिन् पुरुषे भोग मोक्षौ न संभवतः. कथम संभवतः? व्हेन वी आस्क व्हाट डिड यू से, ओ यू आर राइट, बट तथापि यू सेड यद्यपि although your objection is valid, tathapi jnana sukha dukha raga dvesha adaya buddhe parinama bhavanti. We say okay, tasya buddhe atmana saha aviveka asti. We say okay, viveka astuna asti. So far so good. Tasmad atmani aropitav bandha mokshav sambhavata. We say very good. This is what we also accept. Now the problem is that this doesn't prove nanatva of atma at all. Only if the bandha, rags, sukha, dukha, raga, dvesha, bandha, moksha, any dharma, if you accept in atma, then only nanatva is established of atma. So you don't accept it at all. Then why do you insist on nanatva of atma? So taucha bandha moksha sankhya mate asangya atmani nangi kriyete. You don't accept bandha moksha to be real for atma. Kintu buddhya vivekat bandha buddhi vivekat bandhat mokshascha angi kriyete tanmate. So sankhya mat, in the sankhya mata, the aviveka with buddhi. Buddhya avivekaha buddhya vivekaha. Tasmad buddhya vivekat kaha siddhyati. Bandha siddhyati. So bandha siddhyet can be established. You can say there is bandha. Why? Because you consider yourself buddhi, which is baddha buddhi. Buddhi has bandhana. Sukshma sharira is samsari. Buddhi is samsarini. You, however, atma are nitya mukta. Unfortunately, you find yourself entangled with buddhi. You cannot disentangle yourself. Therefore, buddhya vivekat bandha. If you inquire into it, then buddhi vivekat bandhat mokshaha. Let buddhi have bandha. What do you have to do with that bandha? Because you have nothing to do with buddhi at all. Use that very buddhi, free yourself, and then let it go. Just like you light a fire, you don't hold on to the stick with which you light that fire. You light the fire, you set the fire on fire, then let that piece of wood go. So use this buddhi for viveka, separate yourself out, and then drop that buddhi, which is just a karana. Don't need to segment yourself as, oh, I am baddha, I am mukta now. You have ever been mukta. Yadvastu avivekad utpadyate vivekachanashyati tadvastu rajjusarpavat mithya. So then we introduce this word mithya to him. This is what is happening with your darshana also. You are unable to see sat and mithya. Whatever is mithya is not creating sadbheda. So atma is one, nanatva is mithya. So yadvastu avivekad utpadyate. This utpatti of bheda is due to what reason? Nanatva of atma due to what reason? Due to aviveka. Because bandha is due to being separate from everything else. You find yourself as a limited entity. A wanting person trying to become purna. That is the samsari. So bhedaha, bandaha, mokshaha, avivekad utpadyate, vivekaccha nashyati, tad vastu rajju sarpavat mithya. It is like rajju sarpa. As long as you do not know the difference between rajju and sarpa, as mithya, the difference is mithya. Difference is mithya in a sense. There is no sarpa at all. There are many ways to see this. Sarpa isn't existing. Rajju alone is existent. You do not know the Rajju. You know only the sarpa. Then when you inquire into it, then sarpaha nashyati. But what happens? Rajju remains. Therefore, this buddhi having bandha and moksha, atma having no bandha and moksha, due to misunderstanding is due to this aviveka, it is continuing. But once you have viveka as to where is the dharma, then that mithya dharma cannot affect you. Atmani buddhya vivekat bandha bhavati vivekatcha sa bandha nivartate atascha atmani bandha mithya. Yatha bandha mithya tatha atmani mokshopi mithya eva. So bandha is mithya, moksha is mithya. Because the bandha belongs to buddhi, freeing yourself from that buddhi is moksha. You were never baddha to have mukti because you misunderstood the buddhi dharma as your dharma. You thought yourself to be baddha, but you were never baddha. Therefore, moksha is also what? Mithya. Yatra bandha satyah tatra mokshopi satyo bhavet. Atmani bandhasya mithyatvat mokshopi mithya eva. So we don't have any issue saying that moksha is mithya. Oh, how can moksha be mithya? The entire pursuit of several janmas is useless, nishphala. Why? Because moksha is mithya. Oh, it is not nishphala. There is phalavat phalam. The dukkha is felt because of sarpa, there is the bhaya is really felt, and the freedom from bhaya, that sukha is also really felt when you know that there is no sarpa at all. Similarly, bandha taken as real, there is real dukkha felt, and when you drop that misunderstanding that I've always been free, I have nothing to do with the buddhi dharma, then the sukha is also really felt. So it is not nishphala. Had bandha been satya, then moksha would be satya. In fact, moksha would be impossible. That is not mentioned here, but moksha would be impossible if bandha is real. Because what is real will never go away. It will come back. Atmani bandhasya mithyatvat mokshopi mithya eva. Ittham mithya bandha moksho akashavad ekasmin atmani yujyete. It is tenable to have bandha and moksha in the same single atma, like the dharma superimposed on akasha, which is single, which is asanga, which is vyapaka. Similarly, atma is ekaha, vyapakaha, asangaha, still avivekat sambhavati. All these bandha moksha sambhavata, yujyete, atmani yujyete. It's, they are added by buddhi, by erroneous thinking, they are superimposed on oneself. It is tenable. Tasmad bandha moksha bhedad atma bhedaha na siddhyati. Just because bandha is there, moksha is there, bandha is not moksha, moksha is not bandha, they are different, they are totally opposite to each other. Due to that kind of bheda, atma bheda is not established. Tasmat sankhya bhi matatma bhedaha na yuktaha. So tasmat sankhya abhimata atma bhedaha na yuktaha. So atma bheda nanatvam, which is accepted in sankhya, is not logical, it is not tenable. Atra ima bheda badaka yuktayaha. So these are the logical analysis which contradict the sankhya mata logic. So, which was said by the Tippanakara, currently only Shruti Virodha is being mentioned. Advaita Shruti Virodha. If Nana Atma, so Nana Atma Abhyupa तव सॉरी नानात्व अभ्युपगमे सो नाना आत्म अभ्युपगमे सती श्रुति विरोधः विच वाज शोन देयर एंड देन ही हैज सेड प्रदर्शिष्यन्ते इट विल बी शोन व्हाट विल बी शोन दीज युक्तीज विच आर भेद बाधक सो नानात्म बाधक युक्तीज आर प्रेजेंटेड नाउ एकस्य आत्मनः भेदः अन्यस्मिन् आत्मनि विद्यते इति वदन् वादी प्रष्टव्यः सो वन हू सेज देयर इज भेद बिटवीन व्हाट आत्मा एंड आत्मा ही इज यूजिंग तर्क सो वी हैव ऑलरेडी शोन श्रुति विरोध अद्वैत श्रुति विरोध इज देयर आत्मा इज एकमेव अद्वितीय सो एकमेव अद्वितीय ब्रह्म आत्मा एंड योर दर्शना विच हैज नाना आत्मा देयर इज अ विरोध सो ऑब्वियसली यू आर रॉन्ग श्रुति कैन नॉट बी रॉन्ग Then he uses some kind of logic. Now, in that logic, we ask him, this Bheda, what is this Bheda really? He'll say that Atma 1, Atma 2, both have Bheda. Why? Because Atma 1 has a Dharma, which is Atma 2 Bheda. Bheda from Atma 2 is a Dharma in Atma 1. And in Atma 2, there is a Dharma, which is an attribute, which is difference from Atma 1. This is what he is really talking about. Because when he uses Tarka, we have to get to that level of his Tarka and say, Ekasya Atmanaha Bhedaha Anyasmin Atmani Vidyate. You have, so we take two Atmas now that he talks about and we ask him, this Atma which is one for us is Nana for you. So between one Atma and another Atma, what is the Bheda? Where is this Bheda? What is this? This Bheda from one Atma is there in another Atma. And vice versa. Iti Vadan Vadi Prashtavya. So that person who is having this kind of a Sankhya. So Sankhya who is arguing this and others also really. Others who argue about Nana Atma, they should be asked this question. What should be asked? सह भेदः किं भेदरहित आत्मनि वर्तते उत भेद सहित आत्मनि इति सो दिस इज तर्क यू नो यू बीट द तार्किका विथ हिज ओन तर्क सो यू बीट द सांख्या विथ हिज ओन तर्क यू आस्क हिम बाय तर्क यू आर एस्टैब्लिशिंग भेद यू कैनॉट एस्टैब्लिश व्हाई आई विल शो यू व्हाई दिस भेद दैट यू टॉक अबाउट इज इट देयर In Atma, yes. He has to say yes. Because how is Bheda established? It is there in Atma. Now, this Bheda, is it in the Atma which already has Bheda or it does not have Bheda? So, Bheda as a Dharma has to rest in Atma. Now, what is that Atma in which you are showing this Bheda? Is it Bheda Sahita Atma or Bheda Rahita Atma? So, sabheda kim bheda rahita atmani vartate uta bheda sahita atmani iti. So, first option is, it is in that atma, this bheda rests in that atma, which does not have any bheda. Only when you add bheda as an attribute to atma, then that atma will be bheda sahita atma. So, in that first case, prathama pakshe vyaghata dosho bhavati. There is a contradiction. Why? Anya pratiyogikam. भेदाश्रयम आत्मानं भेदरहितं ब्रवीषि यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट आत्मा विच कैन टेक भेद सो अन्य प्रतियोगिक भेदाश्रयम आत्मानं दैट आत्मा विच कैन टेक भेद इज भेदरहित देयर इज अ कॉन्ट्राडिक्शन That Atma, which is Bheda Raita, is going to become Bheda Sahita. Paschat Tatra Atmani Bhedam Cha Sadhayasi. You are showing that Bheda to enter that Asanga Atma really, where Bheda isn't there and then you are showing Bheda there. Tadidam Te Vachanam Mama Pita Balyadarabhya Brahmachari Iti Vachanam Miva Vyaghata Doshas Skanditam. So it is like saying that, you know, my father has been a brahmachari all along. So it is mithya. You cannot be a putra of a brahmachari father there. So it is that kind of an argument. You are saying that where is this Bheda? This Bheda is in that Atma, which is Bheda Rahita Atma. How can the Bheda be in a Bheda Rahita Atma? It cannot be. To say that Atma is Bheda Rahita and saying that there is Bheda in it is contradictory. How is it not contradictory? It is contradictory. Iti vachanam iva vyaghata dosha skanditam bheda sahite atmani. In the second paksha, what happens? Bheda sahite atmani bhedo vidyate iti ditiya pakshe atma yena bhedena sahita asti sabhedaha sadhyamana ayam bhedascha kim parasparam abhinnau utabhinnau. Now in the second option, I would like to change my answer. What is the answer? I think that earlier I made a mistake. You are right. There is vyaghata dosha. There is contradiction. So let me correct it. The Atma which has Bheda is already Bheda Sahita. Now we ask him that Bheda Sahita Atma on which this Bheda rests. That Bheda, second Bheda that you are pointing out now, because it is already Bheda Sahita. That Bheda Sahita Atma has Bheda, so Bheda 1. And now you are proving it is going to have another Bheda, this second Bheda, Bheda 2. What is the difference between Bheda 1 and Bheda 2 now? So Atma yena bhedena sahita asti sa bheda sadhyamana ayam bhedascha kim parasparam abhinnau uta bhinnau. Are they same or they are different? So are you saying that Bheda 1 and Bheda 2 are same or they are different? Are they really 2 or 1? Tatra adhya pakshe, when you say they are parasparam abhinna, there is no difference between Bheda and Bheda 2. I am establishing that Bheda, which is the Bheda that I am establishing in that Atma, that is the same Bheda which is there in the Atma. If that is the case, yena bhedena sahita atma asti sa atmana visheshana rupaha bhedaha. Sorry. Atma yena bhedena sahita asti sa bheda sadhyamana ayam bhedascha kim parasparam abhinnau uta bhinnau. Tatra adhya pakshe swasahite atmani swasya vidyamanatta iti atma shraya doshaha. If you say they both are same, then that bheda cannot be in the bheda which is already there. Atma already has bheda. In that you cannot have the same bheda. Atma shreya dosha. Resting on itself. You cannot have something resting on itself. Yena bhedena sahita atma asti sa atmana visheshana rupa bheda. Sadhyamanastu bheda tata anya iti parasparam bhinnau iti chet. If you say no, they are two different things. There is no atma shreya dosha. Bheda 1 and Bheda 2 are different. Then tada atmana visheshana rupa bhedasya bheda rahite atmani asambhavad bheda sahite atmani eva tasya avasthiti vaktavya. So too complicated. This is what tarka is. If they take to tarka, we have to refute with tarka. So there is bheda in tarka. I mean, there is contradiction in tarka also. So if you accept that bhedas are different, then also you have problem. So yena bhedena sahita atma asti sa atmana visheshana rupa bhedaha. Atma already has that bheda as a visheshana. Sadhyamanastu bheda tata anyaha. That bheda too that you are establishing in that atma, which is bheda sahita atma, anyaha iti parasparam bhinnau iti cha chet. So if you say they are two different bhedas, paraspara bhinna, then tada atmana visheshana rupa bhedasya bheda rahite atmani asambhavat. That visheshana, how did that get in? That bheda also you have to establish. Earlier you said that this bheda that I am showing is in a bheda rahita atma. There we showed the Vyaghata doshas. Bheda rahita atma cannot have bheda at all. It is contradictory. Now you are saying that it is bheda sahita atma. Bheda sahita atmani bhedaha siddhyamanaha yaha. So let me ask you the second bheda which you are going to establish in the bheda sahita atma. That bheda sahita atma is having bheda as visheshana. How did that get in? Visheshana rupa bhedasya bheda rahita atmani asambhavat. That is also not possible. Then you have to say what? No, the visheshana is also in bheda sahita atma. It is not in bheda rahita atma. So bheda rahita atmani bheda na siddhyet. You have to say that it is in bheda sahita atma. That bheda sahita atma has bheda as visheshana. How did that visheshana get in what kind of atma? Is it bheda sahita or bheda rahita? It cannot be bheda rahita because of the earlier vyaghata dosha shown. How about bheda sahita atma? Oh, how did that earlier bheda come in? So you can never establish bheda at all. Why? Because tada atmanah visheshana rupa bhedasya bheda rahita atmani asambhavat. Why asambhavat? Earlier it has been shown as vyaghata doshat. Bheda sahita atmani eva tasya avastiti vaktavya. Tasmad atmani prathama bhedasya stitihi sityartham dvitiya bhedaha visheshanatvena vaktavya. Tataha dvitiya bhedasya sityartham prathama bhedo visheshanatvena vaktavya. Tathacha parasparasya sityartham parasparasya apekshastiti anyonyashre doshaha. Then you ask as to this visheshana for the atma as bheda, where did it come from? So if you so show the resting, we have seen it in another prasanga, so I'll just shortcut it as, if you show it as mutually dependent on each other, where is this atma having visheshana, that bheda, where is it resting on? If it is resting on another bheda, then, and that bheda is resting on the first bheda, then there is anyonyashra, mutual dependence. Anyonyashre dosha. Atmani dvitiya bheda stityartham tadashreyasya atmana bheda sahitatva sampadanaya tadvisheshanatvena tritiya bheda angikare tasya tritiya bhedasya stityartham purvavad eva atmana bheda sahitatva sampadaniyam. Tatra tritiya bheda stityartham tadashreyasya atmana prathama bheda visheshanam iti kathane तदा प्रथम भेद सित्यर्थम द्वितीय भेद सित्यर्थम तृतीय भेद पुनश्च तृतीय भेद सित्यर्थम प्रथम भेद अपि अपेक्षते इति चक्रवद् भ्रमणा चक्रक दोषापत्तिः. इफ यू टेक थ्री यू से यू ब्रिंग इन अनदर थर्ड एंड से दैट फर्स्ट रेस्ट ऑन द सेकंड, सेकंड रेस्ट ऑन द थर्ड, थर्ड रेस्ट ऑन द फर्स्ट अगेन, देन देयर इज अ साइक्लिकल दोष. सो म्यूचुअल डिपेंडेंसी, initially contradiction, then so vyaghata dosha, then mutual dependence, anyonyashraya dosha. If you bring a third entity and show a middleman, then there is chakraka dosha, cyclical. Then if you say that no, there are many, you keep on saying for one you bring another, for another you bring yet another, and you keep on doing it, then you will have infinite regress. Yadi tritiya bheda sityartham bhedashrayam atmanam bheda sahitam कर्तुम तस्य विशेषण रूपश्च चतुर्थो भेद अंगीक्रियते ततश्चतुर्थ भेदसित्यर्थं पञ्चम भेदोऽपि अंगीक्रियते तदा प्रमाण रहित भेद धारा रूपानवस्था दोष प्रसंगः. सो विदाउट एनी प्रमाण यू आर जस्ट ब्रिंगिंग वन आफ्टर द अदर टू एस्टैब्लिश दिस विशेषण ऑफ भेद फॉर द आत्मा. देन व्हाट विल हैपन? अनवस्था दोष. तस्माद् आत्मनः परस्पर भेद असंगतः एताश्च भेदबाधक युक्तयः नैयायिकादि सकल भेदवादि सम्मतात्म भेदखंडने अपि योज्याः. सो दीज आर दी युक्तीज विच आर बेस्ड ऑन तर्क, विच इज व्हाट दे आर यूजिंग टू एस्टैब्लिश भेद, एंड दे विल फेल देयर ओन लॉजिक. दिस कैन बी यूज्ड फॉर सांख्या, इट इज शोन फॉर सांख्या बिकॉज सांख्या इज ऑल्सो यूजिंग व्हाट? युक्ति, तर्क. This can be used for everyone who is using tarka. Nayayikas, dvaitins, vishishtadvaitins, karmakandins, yogis, whoever uses it, Buddhists, Jainas, all, they will all fail their own yuktis because they'll have all these doshas. So they calling themselves as logicians or their system based on logic is itself flawed. So we can refute it by showing Shruti Virodha. We can refute it by showing Tarka Virodha also, Yukti Virodha. So that is a refutation of Nayayika. Then Trivida Nayayika Matavarnam. So Sankhya refutation is over. We look at Nayayika Mata. And the refutation that is done with the Yukti will be common across the board. But there will be some specific refutations of Nayayikas we look at in the next part. Sukanityam Saprakasham Vyapakan Namurupe Adhishthanam Buddhya Bodhyam Buddher Drukyattu Nirmala Aparam Sar Vedanta Vidyam Pratyak Paramaha Tadevahannamattu Nirvidhi Nishchitamatihi. Namaste.
Hari Om.